teacher was, and I was playing popular music, but when I turned about 10 years old, my mother volunteered me to play for our Baptist church downtown Austin, Texas, and they did not teach Baptist church music at the University of Texas, and so my mother would get out the hymnals, which are written in four-part harmony, and with the pencil she would write in what I called the Baptist notes. And I'm gonna give you an example of the way my mother played on Sundays. And it doesn't really matter which hymn that I choose, because to me, she made them all sound the same. And they all came out something like this. Well, I learned how to play that style, but growing up at that time in Austin, Texas, there was this guy who moved to our city, and he started bringing in all these different musicians at the Austin Coliseum, and then 6th Street really didn't exist so much back then for music, but it was the start of it, and so this man named Willie Nelson moved to Austin, and it completely kind of changed the Austin area, the music scene. And I remember going to a Willie Nelson concert. Me and my brother would get on our bicycles because we lived close to where the concert hall was, and we would park our bikes under the bushes and sneak in the back door to hear concerts. And this one night, Willie Nelson had a bunch of his friends from Nashville that came, and I was backstage on this side because I wanted to watch the piano player play, and they had this country piano player. I'd never heard a country piano player before, and I was standing next to one of the most beautiful women I'd ever seen. I was talking to her. She had long blonde hair, and I was asking her, I said, "Who is this pianist out here playing?" And I said, "I really like him." And she said, "Oh, he's very famous in Nashville." And I was standing and talking to a new artist named Barbara Mandrell. And so she was going to come on next after this guy. And she said, "Yeah, this guy's really famous." She was real nice to me. And she probably figured I was a kid of somebody that belonged there. And so she said, "Yeah, this guy, his name is Floyd Kramer. And he's playing the piano." And so I thought, I'm going to go home and copy the way this guy plays. And the song that I remember I heard that night was called Last Date. I'll play a bit of it. You'll remember it.
Thank you. Kramer.